In this video, we are going to discuss about thread issues in operating system. While implementing multi-threading, we have to consider certain threading issues. We will discuss all those issues in this video. Here the issues which we need to consider are, first one, fork system call and exec system call. Second one, thread cancellation. Third one, signal handling. Fourth one, thread pools. Fifth one, thread specific data. So we will discuss all these issues one by one. First, let's see about fork and exec system call. Generally, fork and exec system calls are used by a process. If a process calls fork system call, then a new process will be created, which will be exact duplicate copy of its parent process. Let us assume that P1 process calls fork system call. Then let P2 process is created. Now P2 process will be an exact duplicate copy of its parent process, that is P1. That is the use of fork in process. And the next one is exec system call. Exec system call is mainly useful in order to replace that process with a new process. So if exec system call is called by process P2, then in place of this process P2, a new process code will be replaced. Okay, so let it be some program too. So in place of this program, another program will be replaced. So that is the advantage of fork and exec system call in process. Now let's see what will happen when threads calls fork and exec system call. Let us assume that we have a process. Our process contains, let us assume that it contains four threads. Let thread 1 calls fork system call. Let thread 1 calls fork system call. Then how many threads will be created in the process? Does the process created with only one thread, which is the duplicate copy of this thread, or does the process will be created with four threads, duplicate copies of its parent process? So this is the point here. Okay, so here there are two options there. The first option is when exec system call is used after fork system call. If we want to use exec system call after the fork system call, then there is no need to create a process with these many threads. Then it is better to create the process with only one thread. Why? Because after the fork system call, we are calling exec system call. Exec system call replaces this process with a new process. So that is the first option here. So what is the first option? If exec system call will be called after the fork system call, then it is better to create the process with only one thread. Why? Because exec system call will replaces this process with a new process. Let that process contains 10 threads. Now this process will contains all those 10 threads. And the second possible option is if there is no exec system call, that means we have only fork system call, then it is better to create the process with as many threads as in the parent process. Okay, here our parent process contains four threads, so the fork system call can also create the process with these four threads. So this is about what will happen when the thread calls fork system call and exec system call. Now let us consider the second issue. The second issue is thread cancellation. So thread cancellation is nothing but killing the thread and terminating the thread. Okay, here there are two approaches are there while cancelling the thread. The first approach is asynchronous cancellation. The first approach is asynchronous cancellation, whereas the second approach is deferred cancellation. So we have two approaches in order to cancel the threads. The first one is asynchronous cancellation. Asynchronous cancellation means killing the thread immediately, even that thread is busy with several operations. So we should not bother about that. So we have to kill the thread immediately. That is the first approach. Whereas the second approach is allow the thread to terminate by itself. So give some time to the corresponding thread so that that thread will complete all its operations. So once all those operations are completed, then the thread will kill by itself. Okay. So by using these two approaches, we can cancel the thread. It is better to implement deferred cancellation. Why? Because in deferred cancellation, the thread can complete its work. After that, it will kill by itself. Okay. This is about thread cancellation. And the second one is signal handling. Signal means a special notification which is sent from one process to the another process, or a kernel may send that signal to the a process. Okay. We have several types of signals, like if one process wants to kill another process, or if the kernel wants to kill a process, then it sends sig kill message so that that process will be killed. Or if there is an interrupt, then the kernel may send a signal interrupt message to the corresponding process. So likewise, in Linux there are several signals which are useful in order to send notification to the processes. Here the point is, when a process is sending a notification, to whom it has to send the notification? Let us assume that P1 process wants to send signal to P2 process. Let P2 process contains 5 threads. So to which thread it has to send the notification? So to a specific thread it has to send the notification, or to a set of threads it has to send the notification, or to all the threads it has to send the notifications? Okay. So which thread will handle that signal? Okay. So one thread will handle the event, or all the threads will handle the events, or a specific set of threads will handle the events? So depends upon the problem, we have to handle the signals. Okay. And this is about signal handling. So depends upon the problem, we will provide the solution. And the fourth one is thread pools. Nowadays most of the websites are using thread pools. We know that every website will have a web server. Web server accepts a request from the client, and it will allocate that request to the thread. If it let us assume that this is web server, this is client. So client receives a request from the web server, and web server allocates that request to a thread. Now it is the responsibility of T1 to handle that request. If it receives one more request, then it will create one more thread. So it is the responsibility of T2 in order to handle that request. Okay. So here it is very, very complex process. Let us assume that 1 lakh requests are simultaneously sent to the web server. So then how many threads the web server needs to create? 1 lakh threads. So it is a burden on the web server. Okay. Instead of that, it is better to create a thread pool. That thread pool contains lakhs of threads. Lakhs of threads. So whenever web server receives a request from the client, then web server allocates that request to the one of the thread in the thread pool. So now there is no need to create the thread. Okay. So the burden on the web server will decreases. Okay. Instead of creating 1 lakh threads, already those 1 lakh threads are available in the thread pool, so that web server allocates those requests to the one of the threads. And the last issue is thread specific data. We know that we know what is a multi-threading system. So multi-threading means a process will have multiple threads. So multiple threads can share with one another. So one thread can share with one another with the help of the data segment. In data segment we can store global variables. So one thread can read the data from the global variable, as well as another thread can write some data into the global variable. So that is the one of the advantage of the multi-threading. One of the major advantage of the multi-threading is data sharing. So data sharing is very, very easy in multi-threading. So as well as here, the point is each thread may have its own specific data. Let we have a process with 5 threads. So thread 1 may use its own specific data. Thread 2 may use its own specific data. Thread 2 may use its own specific data. So for that, in every programming language, we have its own syntaxes. If you take C#, we can create our own thread variables with the help of those syntaxes. If we have Java threads, we have our own syntaxes in order to create Java threads. We have P threads, POSIX thread. So in that also, we will be having some syntaxes in order to create our own thread specific data. So these are the 5 thread issues which we need to be considered while implementing a threads in the operating system.